Hi, my name is Amanda Klein, and I am the STEM manager at the Girl Scouts of Eastern Iowa and Western Illinois. That means that I get to prepare and facilitate STEM programs and trainings for girls and leaders throughout my whole council. Today, I am going to help you get started on the Cybersecurity Safeguards badge. You will explore some of the types of data collected by websites and apps that you use every day and learn about your digital footprint. By the end of this activity, you will know how to better control and protect your data online. The internet is a fantastic tool. You can chat with friends, research school papers, play games, watch videos, or listen to music. The downside is that you leave information about yourself behind with every screen tap and mouse click. Some programs, like social media, allow you to share personal information. But every program, app, and website that you use collects data and metadata about you. It is a good idea to think carefully about what data you're sharing and where. The materials you need are 7 sheets of paper, a black marker, and 2 different colored markers. You're going to create an inventory of your online data. This activity will take you about 20 minutes to complete. First, use your black marker to put headings on your 7 sheets of paper as follows: email, messages, and chat, social media and networking, online banking and shopping, media, videos, photos, and music, news and information, games, and school-related. Now, think about the types of apps and online services that you use most regularly across these categories. Jot them down with a marker on the appropriate paper. For example, Instagram would go on the paper labeled social media and networking. YouTube would go on the piece of paper labeled media. Now, think about the different kinds of data that you have stored on each app or website. For example, do you have an account? If you do, you probably have a username and password. Is your parents' credit card information there for any reason? Have you made some in-app purchases maybe? What about your address or your phone number? Have you created a specialized playlist or listed your preferences on a profile somewhere? Take about 5 minutes to write down as many types of data that you can think of on the appropriate paper with one of the colored markers. Go from paper to paper as you think of new ideas and try to think of as many things as possible. Next, imagine that a hacker was going to get access to all the data you have listed on these posters. You can only protect 6 pieces of data. Using the other colored marker, draw a star by the data that you think is most valuable and that you should spend the most time trying to protect. Once you've decided, step back and look where the stars are. Ask yourself these questions. What do you think certain pieces of data are more valuable than others? Were you surprised by how much data you've given to those apps and websites? Why or why not? Is there any data that you've given to some of these websites that they don't really need? Have you set up any accounts that you don't really use? Why might that be a problem? What could you do to protect yourself? How can you protect the data that you have stored in those places? Just a few things to remember. One of the very best ways to protect your data is by using strong, unique passwords for every single account you have. You just created an inventory of your accounts and the data that is stored on them. That will help if you are ever hacked. For example, if a hacker breaks into a site that you know stores your parents' credit card information, tell them immediately. Then your parents can cancel that card and get a new one. Today, you learned about your digital footprint and how to safely control your personal data online. Thank you for choosing to do this activity. If you like this video, please share it with another girl. If you aren't a Girl Scout, please join us. you can go to girlscouts.org to learn more. Thank you. Bye.